what to see, what to rent, and what to skip. It's Movie Reviews with Ryan J.
And we're back with the nationally syndicated film critic, Ryan J. On the cusp of the Super Bowl for movie lovers like him, it is, of course, the Oscars. And we're going to get to a few of his predictions in just a bit. But first, we've got some business to take care of. And we're excited to see you Monday, too, because you're going to be back to talk about it post-awards. And
Absolutely.
Paul Warish is going to be here, too, to talk about hair fashion.
It'll be great.
You'll be here without Faye, though.
I know.
But you do fashion, too, so it'll be great.
It'll be fun. A lot
yeah.
of fun. Absolutely.
So what business do we have to take care of?
The new movie is this week.
Okay.
Let's start with The Duff.
All right, okay, sounds good.
It's a new romantic comedy for the high school set, and it's cast really well, but it's really typecasting. So you have the pretty girl cast as the mean girl, mm-hmm. the hot guy cast as the captain of the football team, and then, of course, the lead is like kind of a smart nerd, and she's adorable. She was in Mae Whitman. She was in Perks of Being a Wallflower. She's adorable.
But you didn't find this very original?
No, it's super derivative. It reminds me so much of Mean Girls, Easy A, Pretty in Pink, and Grease. It has that whole theme of like a girl has to change herself for a guy, which we've seen a million times, so that's a little frustrating.
I don't like the title. What is it? It stands for Designated
Ugly Fat Friend.
Right.
Oh.
Well, hopefully there's a good message.
Here's the thing.
The
chances are, if you don't know what it is, you were one.
But
the thing is,
I don't know what that is.
I didn't know either. And apparently, and they say this in the movie too, to be a Duff, you don't have to actually be ugly or fat. It just means that you were the wingman for your hotter friends, which I certainly was.
I was too.
I think
definitely.
I am to this day. When I'm hanging out with you and Tiffany, I'm the Duff, let's be honest. So the movie's, it's cute, but it's just not very original. It has a little bit of a modern twist with some cyberbullying that happens.
Yeah, there's social networking
involved. Yeah, there's some cyberbullying. And the thing is like, you know, I was bullied in high school and I was traumatized by it. And mm-hmm. one of the worst things happens to this girl in the film. And like, she makes it through the day. I'm like, what? She didn't like run home crying. So that was a little bit implausible to me.
Is there a moral to this movie?
There is. There's a really great message at the end, which I really appreciated. I don't know that the kids that are, you know, in the target audience are really going to get the message. But I think it's okay. This one's a rental. For those of us who have seen the better films, the classic films, The Pretty in Pinks and The Mean Girls, like those movies are better, so this is more of a rental to catch at home someday.
All right, got it.
So McFarland, USA.
Yeah, this is the new Disney movie starring Kevin Costner as a high school cross-country coach. It's based on a true story, which in reality is very nice, but on the big screen, not so much.
Doesn't translate,
really? Not very cinematic.
Mm-hmm. It seems like now all of a sudden he's in every movie again. It's kind of weird.
Yeah.
He's having sort of a, does it seem like it's due to a resurgence?
Yeah, he has. He just did Black or White recently also, so it's true.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. What about the pacing of this?
It's very slow. This movie is 2 hours long and it's really lengthened by the subplots, which completely take focus away from the main story of the film. So I was a little frustrated by that.
It's a little bit of a sports movie. I was watching an interview with some of the people that are on the team that mm-hmm. they cast, and they were all supposedly newcomers talking about how difficult it was to train for.
Yeah.
But how does it compare to other sports movies?
It doesn't compare well. You know, I'm not a sports fan. There isn't one sport where I'm like, ooh, I'm excited about it. But I love sports movies because whether or not you like the sport, if a sports movie is good, it connects with you emotionally, it becomes rousing, you are invested in the story and the characters, there are moments you might get emotional, you might cry. This movie was not inspired at all. I just sat and watched this movie, and as a matter of fact, I did something in this movie I've never done before. In the last half hour, I checked my watch 4 times.
No way.
That's how bored I was.
Ooh, okay.
So this is a skip it.
Skip it.
Skip
yeah.
it. Wow. Okay, Kevin, you got to step it up if you want to be in all these movies lately. What about the last 5 years? This one's rated PG-13, right?
It is, and it's a new movie musical. It's based on a successful off-Broadway show, and this one stars Anna Kendrick, who we love, and also Jeremy Jordan, who was on TV's Smash, and he originated the role of Jack Kelly on Broadway's Newsies, and they have phenomenal voices, and they're great to look at, just so talented.
So it's obvious. Obviously a unique storytelling event.
Very unique. The whole thing is pretty much sung, and the songs sound a lot like Rent, so they're not typical show tunes, but he tells the perspective of their relationship from the beginning to the end, and she sings her perspective from the end of the relationship backward, so it's kind of sounds confusing, but it's really cool how it works.
It's
not hard to follow. It's very unique. It's interesting. When you go in knowing that, it's helpful, but it's a very unique, different kind
of
thing.
Was she in Pitch Perfect?
Yes.
Okay.
That's her.
Because I saw one critic say, just proves that Anna Kendrick can do no wrong. And I was like, it's wow, she's that's so like high
and
praise.
Right, and she's Cinderella in Into the Woods. Okay. You know, so she's just fantastic.
Right, well, what is it, the triple threat? When you see someone that can act, and then you're like, oh, really? They can sing too? Come
yeah,
on.
It's true.
Pass it around a little
so
bit.
So good.
What does it say about relationships?
It's really interesting. I think there's something in it for everyone we can all relate to. Like, whether or not you're experiencing exactly what this couple experiences, we all have that same infatuation and excitement and good intentions at the beginning of a relationship, the same heartbreak when it doesn't work out at the end. So I really was touched by this movie, and I think you should give it a shot. I say see it. It's available now on demand. It's not playing in town, but I watched it on iTunes, and so you can seek it out for digital download that way, and it's definitely worth seeing.
Well, and we teased this earlier. We're like, the best new movie this weekend is one you can watch from your own couch and not even go out in the cold because
you
can download it, which is really cool. What do you want to say about the Oscars coming up Sunday night?
I'm very excited. I really thought at the beginning of award season that it was going to be a very unpredictable season and we'd be seeing different actors winning different shows, but it's been pretty predictable, and it looks like Boyhood is going to take Best Supporting Actress Patricia Arquette, Best Picture, Best Director, probably looking at Michael Keaton for Best Actor, Julianne Moore for Best Actress, and of course Best Supporting Actor J.K. Simmons for Whiplash, which is really the one movie everyone should be seeing. You know how like Best Picture usually goes to an art type movie, but it should go to like the one movie that was like the most awesome, most exciting.
Epic.
Whiplash is that movie among the nominees this year.
Is there anyone that you'd really like to see win that you don't think is going to?
I would have liked to have seen Into the Woods be nominated.
Right.
You know, so it wasn't. I think it might have like a costume nomination or something, but that's about it. So
Whiplash is a movie we're going to see together sometime soon.
Yes, I'm holding that one on because I want to watch that with
and
you.
And what movie is Julianne Moore in?
Still Alice.
Still Alice. Okay, awesome. That's the one that you think might win for Best Actress.
Best Actress, absolutely.
Awesome. Great to see you, Ryan.
You too.
Awesome
job,
like usual, with this purple shirt and our purple cards. I love it. We're going to get to see him again on Monday because he's going to review the Oscars for us and talk fashion, which I love it when he does that. So you can like Ryan J on Facebook, follow him on Twitter, and for his full movie reviews, check out his website. It's ryanjreviews.com.